Hi, my name is Mike Foley. I'm Staff Technical Marketing Architect at VMware in the vSphere Tech Marketing Team. This is another edition of Quick Bites. And with me today is my colleague, Myles Gray. And our first meeting, we're going to talk about VM service, a new capability that just showed up in vSphere 7 Update 2A. And Myles, why don't we start with what do you do here at VMware?
So I work in technical marketing as well. I'm a staff technical marketing engineer focused on the developer experience on vSphere with Tanzu. So everything higher level than the platform. So VM service, namespace self-service. What can you actually do with the platform once it's up and running?
Excellent. And so as I mentioned, you're here to talk about VM service. Give us a quick rundown on what VM service is, what it brings to customers, and so forth.
So VM service is a couple of things. First of all, it is an operator built on top of our supervisor cluster. So it's built into vSphere with Tanzu, and it gives you the ability to provision virtual machines through Kubernetes manifests. So say you have a content library with your OVAs in it, it'll let you as the Kubernetes user, developer, SRE, whatever you want to call that persona, the ability to deploy VMs from those content libraries that you've been entitled to based on t-shirt sizes that are provided by the VI admin. We call those VM classes. And it lets you do a bunch of other stuff like customizing guest OS, all this kind of thing. So really the high level feature is if you have an application that you're modernizing or that, you know, has some dependencies on VMs and isn't fully containers based, which let's be frank, is quite a lot of them, then this lets you bring those in as part of your CI/CD system, automation system. You can manage your VMs the same way you manage your Kubernetes-based applications.
Okay, cool. So as a developer, this is all running on vSphere. Do I need to know vSphere APIs or anything like that?
Yeah, no, absolutely not. So the whole point of VM service and our supervisor cluster is that we abstract vSphere and vCenter into Kubernetes native APIs. So no vSphere API knowledge. You don't even have to have, you know, a vSphere account. You know, it can be federated through AD or whatever, you know, through the vSphere SSO system whenever you log in. So you don't have to interact with VC. You don't have to understand vSphere. You don't have to understand how it deploys things. All you need to know is, here's the images that you can use. Here are the sizes that you can deploy it in. And then away you go. You deploy it and you use Cloud Init or whatever templating engine that you want to use. We have Cloud Init by default. And then that lets you customize the guest operating system, add it into config management systems, what have you.
So I read your blog and it said that VMware is providing images. Can I bring my own images today?
Not right now, no. And there are a couple of reasons for that. First of all, this is V1 Alpha 1. It's the very first version of VM service, VM operator. And we wanted to make sure that we adequately test all this stuff. You know, that we know there are some problems with some things. And, you know, it's our first version. We'd really love feedback on what images you want next, what features you would like to see. But out of the box, what we're shipping at the moment is CentOS. So we have a version of CentOS that is very, very lightly modified that we've put up on the VMware Marketplace. You can download that or subscribe to that content library and you'll have access to it. We're hoping to provide some other images in the near future, but really the sort of ideal goal and, you know, in the short to medium term, we're hoping to just get rid of restrictions altogether and let you use whatever images. But for, you know, right now, the very first version, we have limited it somewhat just to make sure that we can focus on the things that matter.
So I'll put a link to the blog down below in the show notes. One other question I had. So as a vSphere admin, you had mentioned this thing called Cloud Init. How does that compare to guest operating system customizations that I do within the vSphere client?
Yeah, that's a good question. So they are somewhat the same, but also very different at the same time. So guest OS customization would do host name settings, IP addressing, the basic, you know, customization that you need for a VM. And doesn't go much beyond that. Like it was never a goal of guest OS customization to go beyond that. Cloud Init is different. Cloud Init does those things, but it does basically everything else as well. So it's got built-in modules for like package installations, adding repos, installing packages, updating stuff, you know, setting time, setting host names, everything, you know, DHCP networking, static networking, whatever. But it can also run arbitrary commands too. So, you know, with the ability to run arbitrary commands, you can literally do anything in the OS. You can write arbitrary files or whatever.
This sounds like a different mindset from building a template with everything pre-installed and then just adding it to the domain, giving it an IP address and a name to almost like a Linux Kickstart, where I start with a bare bones Linux installation and I add in all of the components according to a recipe or manifest. Does that sound right?
Oh, there are definitely some parallels with Kickstart. Yeah, where Kickstart is what you use to pixie boot something and initialize the OS, stream down the OS image to disk. Cloud Init does kind of the same thing, but at a higher level, like after post-install, run commands on the OS that are installed. So very, very similar to Kickstart. Different syntax, but you know the idea is the same.
So the images that these CentOS images that live in the content library are just a basic bare bones Linux, and then I use Cloud Init to do not only the customization of the operating system, but also the addition of all the applications and all the configuration. And that way I can literally put that script or such under source control. Right. Mm-hmm,
exactly. And that's the thing. Whenever you're using Cloud Init, and because it's through Kubernetes, it's desired state too. So if you're using, you know, Git to manage your Kubernetes manifest, which you should be,
that's actually probably a good topic for another video.
For sure. But if you are using source control for this stuff, which you should be using source control, then yeah, it brings your customizations under source control as well. So it makes sure that everything is always consistent. If something breaks, roll it back. You've got versioning on it, you know, so it doesn't matter. Likewise, you know, there are other schools of thought about how you manage the guest OS. So some people put everything in Cloud Init, let it do all the package installation, absolutely everything. Other people, they use Cloud Init more as a bootstrap. It sets the host name, DHCP networking, and then installs your config management tool of choice, Puppet, Salt, Chef, whatever you're going to use. If you're using Ansible, you don't need an agent, but maybe install some SSH keys or whatever in there, and then let your config management solution take over at that point. So there are a couple of approaches to it. No one is wrong, no one is right, but there are options.
Right. So to wrap this up, how do we get this VM service stuff?
So VM service stuff is included as part of vCenter 7.0 U2A. You don't need to update your ESXi hosts. If they're still on U2, that's fine. But you do need to install vCenter. And once you've updated your vCenter, you'll have to update your supervisor cluster, because that's when we install the Kubernetes operator. So update your VC first, update your supervisor.
Yeah, I just saw that the other day when I updated mine from Kubernetes 1.18 to 1.19. And when I looked in my namespace, there was a new panel called VM Service.
Simple as that.
Cool. All right. So I think that's about it. That sounds pretty straightforward. I don't want to say easy, but it does sound straightforward. And thanks for joining us and talking about VM Service.
Thank you, Mike.
All right. Take care.